And now we will learn how to set the billing preferences. This is also called the billing defaults. Right now, by default, expenses per job are marked as billable automatically. And putting our expenses on a client's invoice makes the expense for us become zero. Let's change the default so the job-related expenses are not automatically marked as billable. From the main menu, we click Edit Preferences. We scroll all the way down to Time and Expense, the very last category of preferences. In the Company Preference tab, we're going to click Mark All Expenses as Billable. Now, it's set this way by default, but if we click to remove the check mark, that means when we record a check or enter a bill from a vendor, it will not automatically mark it as billable, and we will have to place the check mark ourselves. Click OK, and let's take a look at our first example. On March 1, we paid check number 3 to Grecon for a demolition service for the Hanson Place job, Brown Company, $300. From the main menu, click Banking, write a check. The date has to be put forward or backward, depending on when you're watching this video, to March 1 of 2017. The company we paid was Grecon Demolition. Now, the amount we paid was $300. On the left of your keyboard, push the Tab key, go to the bottom left, and choose the expense, Demolition Expense. But this is demolition expense specifically for the Hanson Place job under Brown Company. Aha! Notice the billable box is not checked off by default. That's because a moment ago we removed that option in the preferences window. It just so happens this is billable, so we'll click the check mark and we'll click Save and Close. Now when we open the unbilled cost by job, we see that check will be there until we bill Brown for that particular demolition job. Now let's see if it works on a bill. March 2nd, we received bill number 7171 from UPS for a delivery that relates to the Hanson Place job, $200. Let's take a look at how to record. From the main menu, click Vendor, Enter Bill. The date on the bill is March 2nd. The reference number on the bill is 7171. The money amount of the bill is $200, and the vendor is UPS. We go down to the bottom left and click directly under the word account. Click on the arrow and choose Delivery Expense. Now we're almost done. We just have to tell QuickBooks that this particular expense is for the Hanson Place job. Notice when we chose Brown Company Hanson Place job, the check mark is not there in the billable box because we removed the default. Let's click to place it ourselves, then we'll click Save and Close. And now when we look at the unbilled cost by job, we can see that that bill is on this report waiting to be placed on an invoice. The next billing default we will discuss is tracking reimbursable expenses as income. Now you may well ask, what does it mean to track reimbursable expenses as income? It means when billable expenses are added to a client's invoice, the expense stays in the expense account, and the reimbursed expenses are added to the income of that invoice. Now, this is different behavior than we saw in the previous video. What are the steps to set up the track reimbursable expenses as income feature? First, we have to check the box in the preferences window. Let's do that now. From the main menu, click Edit, Preferences. Now scroll down to the same place we were earlier, time and expense. Click the Company Preference tab, and now we will click the check mark here. Track reimbursed expenses as income. Now we click OK, and step one is finished. Now let's discuss the next two steps. We have to create matching income accounts for the reimbursable expenses that we wish to track as income. After we create these accounts, we will edit the original expense accounts to be able to connect them to the matching income account. Now, what does that mean, matching account? Well, in our previous example, we had demolition expense, and that means we have to create an account called demolition fees that will hold the income when we put the reimbursable billable expense of demolition onto the invoice. Same thing with delivery expense in our previous example. We have to create an account called delivery fees that will track and record the income that we put on the invoice when we ask the customer to reimburse us for delivery expense. So, let's do this. Let's create a matching income account for the reimbursable expenses that we wish to track as income. We can open the chart of accounts from the main menu, List, Chart of Accounts. From the bottom left, click Account New. Now, these accounts are income accounts. Click Continue, and we will put Demolition Fees. And then we'll click Save and New. Make sure the account type stays income, and we will put delivery fees. Click Save and Close, and these will be the income accounts that will record the income when we put the billable delivery and billable demolition on to an invoice. And now the final setup step, edit the expense accounts of those expenses to connect them to the matching income account. Very simple. If you don't have the chart of accounts still open, you should reopen it. And now let's go to delivery expense. Click on it, then click Account, Edit Account. We have to click this checkbox, and then from the delivery expense account edit window, after clicking the checkbox that says Track Reimbursed Expenses as Income, click the arrow and find the matching income account, in this case, delivery fees. So it will be delivery expense before we are reimbursed, and it will be delivery fees after we are reimbursed by the client. Click Save and Close, and we'll do the same thing for demolition expense. Click on it, click Account, Edit, click the check mark next to the box that says Track Reimbursed Expenses in Income Account, and we will choose the demolition fees. Now click Save and Close. Now we're ready to enter invoices where we can put the reimbursed expenses and they will show up as income. Now let's see if it works. Let's imagine on March 5th, we billed Brown Company for 10% more of the Hanson Place job, and we will include the March 1 demolition from Grecon from check number 3. Before we record the invoice, let's take a quick look at the profit and loss by job. Right now, we have demolition expense 300. After we make the invoice and put this expense on the invoice, this expense will now stay, which is not what happened in the previous video when the preference was set differently. But in addition to this staying, you will see for the first time demolition fees show up in the income section of this report. Let's take a look at how to record it. Open the invoice, move the date forward to March 5th of 2017. Now choose the Hanson Place job under Brown Company, and of course we're taking the information from the main estimate. Click OK. Just like in a previous video, we click Create Invoice as a percent. The instruction said we finished 10% more of this job since the last invoice. When we click OK, Not only does it populate the invoice with 10% of the estimate, but it also has this message popping up, billable time and cost. And yes, we're going to select the outstanding time and cost. Click OK, and we have two expenses. In this case, we're going to click the check mark in the margin of the construction and demolition for $300. When we click OK, the $300 has been added to this invoice. And when we scroll down, we can see $300 has been added to the invoice as a result of what we just did. When we click Save and Close, when we click Save and Close, we can open the profit and loss by job, and we can see the demolition expense is still here, but demolition fees has shown up for the first time in this report in the income section under Hanson Place, because in addition to earning income from heating repair, we also earned income from demolition fees, $300. And of course, our last example, March 7, billed Brown Company for 5% more of the Hanson Place job. We will include the March 2nd bill, number 7171, from UPS for the delivery that relates to the Hanson Place job. Again, we open the invoice window. We move the date forward to March 7 of 2017. We choose the Hanson Place job. Of course, we're still working from this main estimate, so click OK. This time, we're only billing them for 5% additional complete from this job. When we click OK, we have the opportunity to select the outstanding billable time. When we click OK, there's only one expense, so we'll click the check mark in the margin. Then when we click OK, we will scroll down and see that that expense has been added to this invoice. Now, when we click Save and Close, click Save and Close, and we look at the profit and loss by job, now we can see that the delivery expense is still there for the Hanson job, which is opposite from what happened in the previous video. But you can see, even though this is still here, what balances that out is that delivery fees shows up for the first time in the income section under the Hanson Place job.